about two parts of the gospel reading. One is about the story of Nicodemus and being born again, and the other part is John 3:16, which we should all know and understand. Nicodemus is mentioned three times in the Bible. Can you tell me those three occasions? I didn't think so. What?
The one we just heard.
The one we just heard? That's good, Bernie. Very good. You must be Catholic, are you? this is the first time Nicodemus, and he was a Pharisee, and usually they clash, but he had a soft part in his heart for the words of Jesus. And another time when Jesus was being attacked and accused of false teachings, he stepped up and defended Jesus and said, everybody must be given a chance to speak before you condemn them. And then at the death of Jesus, Joseph of Arimathea and Nicodemus helped to prepare the body of Jesus after he died. Now you think I'm very smart, don't you? I just Googled that this morning. Anyway, Nicodemus Jesus talked about being born again. And Nicodemus asked the obvious question, how can a person be born again? How can we go back into the womb of our mothers and be born again? And Jesus said, you're a teacher of the scriptures and you don't understand what this means. How many of you are born again? All raise your hands, please. You're all born again, right? Back in the 70s and 80s, it was a very contentious thing in the Christian church where people would ask you, are you born again? And Lutherans didn't know how to respond, right? We didn't understand what that meant. But here's what it means, is that we are born in the flesh, we are born into this world, and at some time in our lives, or every day of our lives, we must be born into the Spirit of God. And this is a constant thing. Martin Luther said, you are born again and again and again. Every day we go through this rebirth, or we should go through this rebirth. Every day we are drawn by the world. The world calls us. The people of the world and the message of the world and the things of this world, they call us. Come, come to me. Come and accumulate these things and you will be happy. Do the things that the world tells you is right, and you will find the things that you're looking for in your life. And we keep coming up empty. And we still feel an emptiness in our heart. Some people believe that one of the reasons there's so many problems in the world is that stress leads us into the things of the world. We turn to addiction. And alcohol and drugs and pursuing more and more things. We eat more and participate more in worldly things, believing this is how we battle the things that are causing stress in our lives. And God is calling us into a relationship with Him. And like Nicodemus, most of us don't understand what that even means. What does it mean to be born again? To be born in the Spirit. What it means every day is resisting that call from the world and listening to the quiet, silent voice of God calling us into a deeper life, calling us to resist those things of the world, to believe that you are not going to find your happiness and contentment and fulfillment in your heart from these things. That is true. But walking closer with God, listening every day to God's voice, listening to the words of Jesus, where He calls us to a deeper life. He calls us to look after our neighbor's needs rather than our own. To be meditative, to be at peace, to be quiet, to be still. This is the part of the journey that God is calling us to. In John 3:16, how many of you remember Monday Night Football back in the 60s and 70s, where the guy with the crazy hairdo held up the sign? Remember that? John 3:16, right? And I don't know what was going on up here, but millions and millions of people saw John 3:16. For God so loved the world, right? That's the first Bible passage we had to memorize when we were in confirmation class. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, so that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. This is the gospel. Okay, the second part of that, we've made a law in saying, well, you have to believe in him in order to be saved. That's not really what it says. God loved the world. The world did not make themselves lovable. God loved the world. He loved us first. And it's such a powerful love. It's a powerful love that can change our hearts and change our lives. In the next verse, it says, Jesus did not come to condemn the world, but to save the world and to save all of us. So it's time for us to get rid of the if, ands, or buts about Jesus and about our relationship with God. How so many churches list off all the things that you have to do. You have to be born again. You have to speak in tongues. You have to be baptized in this way in order to be saved. God loves you completely and unconditionally. That's the gospel. Amen. Extend our hands to one another. Bless the Lord, O my soul. That's right.